Let us try to understand a set given here. A private power supply company has worked out an innovative plan with a factory to which it supplies power. That means the power supply company to the factory, they will give a power, but with a innovative plan. What is that plan? Factory consumes electricity at the rate of 100 units per hour. 1 hour, 100 units. The power company will charge the factory at the rate of rupees 1.5 per unit. That means 100 units, it should be 150 rupees. 1 hour, it is charging. There may be two types of power shutdowns. It is planned or unplanned type of shutdown. While there is no penalty for planned shutdown, the factory will reduce the payment by rupees 150 for each hour of unplanned shutdown of the power. We need to understand that. It is actually, the scenario is whenever it is going on some power, we need to understand first of all the entire part with some example. If I am writing one example, let's say a 10-hour period. I am considering a 10-hour period. In the 10-hour, let us consider that 6-hour normal. So for that, the factory will pay the amount to the factory. And at what rate per hour it is 150, so 6 hour, 6 into 150, that will be the revenue for the power supply company. But let's say out of 4 hour, 3 hours is planned shutdown. Planned. Whenever planned, then factory will not charge a penalty to the power supply company. But for 1 hour, which is unplanned, if I am finding, at that time, it is at the rate of 150 rupees, it will charge. So 6 multiplied by 150 is the revenue. And this one is a charge. So minus 150, it is a loss for power supply company. That means 5 multiplied by 150 will be the revenue earned by the company at that time. Now, this is my example. This example, it has given you the idea that in which way the power supply company is charging and getting penalty. More than that, the power supply company's operating cost is rupees. That means whenever it is running these the power supply factory at that time, it is a power generation station, it is running. At the time, it is operating cost is rupees 100 per hour during normal operation and 50 rupees per hour during shutdown. And the entire period, which one I have considered as a 10 hour, it is actually 200 hour period given in this table. So entire idea, we can find it out that period one, 200 hour, two, 200 hour in this way, four, 200 hour bracket. And at that time, what is the normal supply? What is the planned shutdown? What is unplanned as a percentage it has given. Now, good number of people immediately after try to go on finding that in which way this 200 hour it will give as per normal supply, how much revenue it will give, how much unplanned shutdown due to that reason, how much the penalty. That good number of people will start thinking. We will not think of it. What we need to do every time whenever we understood the set, our next target is we need to check that question how it is given. So if I know that here some of the things that I need to find it out, what are the things that is written here? As per the questions, we can find it out, because question wise, we can see first question, it is talking about that which period produced the highest revenue. Revenue means what? Amount received minus penalty. What example I have given, that amount received and penalty. That one I need to find for all period and which period is the highest. That is, it is a comparative analysis. Go to the next question. That what is the total, lowest total operating cost? That means only operating cost I need to find. And operating cost wise, I know that for the normal supply, it is 100 rupees. For planned and unplanned, it is 50 rupees. That should be the operating cost. So second question, it is talking about operating cost. Again, it is a comparative. Out of four period, which one is the lowest? Next question, it is the profit, where the profit is lowest. And next one, where profit is the highest. So we can see that for each question, it is a comparative analysis. And after that, I need to tell you one very important thing. As it is comparative analysis, there is no requirement to find it out the actual calculation. What we have to do, we need to find it out the calculation entirely with some kinds of multiplying factor, suitable multiplying factor. I am first trying to go with this revenue part to get the suitable multiplying factor. Please understand period 1, which is a 200 period. This is also 200. Why should I will think of it 200? Let me consider that 80 is the, for the normal supply, it is 80. Bus, consider 80. Hour, nothing. Just 80. That means our revenue will be 80 multiplied by 150. It should be my target. But in case of revenue, what I need to do? Normal supply and unplanned shutdown. These I need to consider. Normal supply, I will get 150 rupees multiplied by 80. Unplanned shutdown, 10 multiplied by 150 minus. So why should I will think of it 150? It is a multiplying factor 1. So revenue will be for period 1, 80 minus 10 only. 70 I will think of it. Because this will give me the comparative analysis for each of the cases. In case of planned, there is no any penalty, but unplanned, there is a penalty. And penalty, what is? At what rate? 150 rupees per hour. And per hour normal supply, what is the revenue? 150 rupees. It is minus, it is plus. So both the cases value is same. Why should I will multiply? I will not. So it is 80 minus 10, 70. Similarly, the next one is 73 minus 5. That is coming as 68. These one 82 minus 13, so it is 69. These one 79 minus 12, that means it is 67. I can see easily that revenue wise, these are the value. And as these are the value, in our first question, if I go to the first question, it has said, which period produced the highest revenue amount received minus penalty, amount received minus penalty? For the power supply company, highest is where it is coming as 70. That means period 1 is my answer in this case. Now, in our second question, we can see that it is a question that which period has the lowest total operating cost. This is operating cost, and to calculate the operating cost, what I have to do, please see the segment here where it has mentioned the operating cost. The power supply company operating cost is 100 per hour during normal operation and 50 per hour during shutdown. So to calculate the operating cost, what are the things that are required? Please find it out. Operating cost, if I want to find it out, this 80 is the normal, planned and unplanned it is 10 10. So can I say that 80 and 10, 10, these are the hour? So that all of them will remain this data, I need not to make any calculation. But for 80, my operating cost is 100 rupees. For 10, it is 50 rupees. So 50 is basically half of it. Can I consider that 80 multiplied by 1, but 10 multiplied by half? And that 10 multiplied by half, these are the cost addition. So my operating cost for the first one is nothing but 80 plus 10 plus 10, 20 by 2, 10 plus 10 by 2, which is nothing but 90. It is my operating cost of the first one as a comparison. Here 50, I have removed, no requirement of that 50. I'm removing this one for operating cost purpose. Here my requirement, here it is 100 at the rate of 100. At the rate of 50, at the rate of 50. And that particular cost, if I make a suitable multiplying factor, it would be 1. If I'm taking this is 1, this would be half. Or if I take this is 1, 1, so it should be double, 2. That's anything. Comparison is required. So my next calculation should be what? 73 plus 22 plus 5 by 2. 22 plus 5 means 27 by 2, 13.5. So it is actually 73 plus 13.5. That means 86.5. Done. Second period. Third period, 5 plus 13, 18, 18 by 2, 18 by 2, 9, 9 plus 81. So it is 90, 91. 9 addition with 82. This one, 9 plus 12, that is 21. 21 by 2, 10.5. So 79 plus 10.5, that is 89.5. Now, in this case, I got my comparison requirement 90, 86.5, 91 and 89.5. Out of that, which one is the lowest? That is my question. So which one I can say as lowest? Lowest is 86.5. So period 2. My answer is period 2. Now we know that next two questions, 19 and 20, we need to go with this profit, because first time it has said profit lowest and next question profit highest. So profit, to make it out, our requirement is both revenue and operating cost. Now, I need to give some idea here that in case of revenue, let me write it down this way. This is period 1, period 2, 3 and 4. I got that revenue. In this case, I have written 70, 68, 69. And 67. But this revenue I have written with a common multiplying factor. I have taken at that time 150 is equal to 1, considering that I have written. Now, in case of operating cost, whenever the data for operating cost is 90, here 86.5, here 91 and 89.5. I can't take this data and this data comparison, because at that time, whenever operating cost I have taken, what I have taken? 80 I have multiplied by 100. This one 50. So it is 100 is the one at that time. 100 is one at that time. But whenever these two I need to compare, it into a common multiplying factor. Means in case of profit, I need to take a common multiplying factor. So as 100 is double of 50 and it is 3 times of 50, so I need to multiply this one by 3 and this one multiplied by 2 and subtract. So at the time, I will take, in the next case, I will consider that for profit, let 50 is equal to 1 for my calculation. So profit for the first one, what should I do? It should be nothing but 70 into 3 minus 90 into 2. That is our profit for the period 1. That means 210, 180, so 30. So my calculation, this one is 30. Check it out, that it should be 68 into 3 means 210 minus 6, so 204. 204 minus 86.5 into 2, that means 86.5 means 90. If I take 180 minus 7, that means 173. So it is coming as 27 plus 4, that is 31. So it is our period 2 profit. Go into that, 69 into 3, that means 210 minus 3, so it is 207. Minus 207 minus 182, double of it. So it is coming as 18 plus 7. So it is 18 plus 7, 25. Go to that, 67 into 3. So it is coming as 9 minus of 210 means 201. 201 minus these into 2. So it is 180 minus 1, 179. That means it is coming as 21, 22. So people, please get this one. What is my comparison now for profit? 30, 31, 25 and 22. These would be my comparison. And if I am taking this comparison, so which profit lowest? Lowest is in this case 22. That means our period 4. So answer for this case, it would remain period 4. So it is actually lowest is period 4. Go to our next one. That means question number 20. So at that time, it is written that profit highest. Highest is 31. So period 2. So these way, 19 and 20 profit we can calculate.